Now I want to demonstrate you how we can read an object and how we can write an object to the file. So for that, let me save this program as demo1.java. I want to write the simple object to the file and I want to read the simple object from the file. So definitely I need the class to create the object. So I'm creating here one class, and that class is student. Now this class has integer roll number, string name, and integer total marks. Now this class has the constructor that is a student, in which I'm taking the input from the user, roll number, name, and total marks. Now I want to assign my instance variable, that is this dot roll number is equal to roll number, this dot name is equal to name, this dot total marks is equal to total marks. You can override the toString method. Whenever the instance is called, you can print the roll number, name, and total marks. So I'm just overriding the method, that is public string toString. And here you can simply return roll number, concatenate with space name, and concatenate with space total marks. So what happened? Whenever the object of student is print, this roll number, name, and total marks will be printed. Now I want to create here one class, and that class is student demo. Let me write here main method, that is public static void main. Now I want to create the object of student. So for example, student s1 is equal to new student, and the value is roll number 101, name for example Kapil Shukla, and the total mark is for example 456. Now I want to display the information of this student. So I'm just writing here system.out.println s1. Whenever you print s1, definitely the details of the student will be displayed on the screen. So you can compile this code, that is Java C demo1.java, and you can run Java student demo. So you will get 101 Kapil Shukla 456. Now I want to write this object into the file. So how we can write the object into the file instead of this printing on the screen? So very simple. Here we can import the package java.io.star. Using the object output stream, we can write the object to the file. So very simple. Here we can write that object output stream OOS is equal to new object output stream. And here you need to mention the object of file. So in which file you want to write this. So here you can mention that new file output stream. And here we need to mention the name of the file, in which file you want to write this. So let me take here one object of a file, that is file. File is equal to new file. And here you can give the name of your file. For example, my name of the file is student.txt. My extension is txt, but still this file will not be readable. Now I want to write this object s1 into this file, that is a student.txt. So using the object of this OOS, you can write that OOS.write object is the function, and you can pass the object that you want to write. So I want to write the object of student. So I'm just writing here os.write object, and here you can simply write that is s1. So what happened in this case? This s1 will be written to the file, that is file output stream. But which file? So here we need to mention file output stream, this file. So what happened? This file is the input of this file output stream. This file output stream is bind with the object output stream. So whenever you write an object to the object output stream, it will write it into the file output stream, and it will write into this file, and this file is the student.txt. You can simply write here os.close. So this object will be written into the file. Whenever you are calling the function write object, and whenever you pass your object must be serialized. This object, that is, you are writing the object S1. So this student must be serialized. If it is not serialized, you will get an error. For example, let me save this You can compile this code and you will get an error. The error is file output stream here. My spelling mistake is there. I need to write it here. That is a file output stream. Now you can save this. Now you can recompile your code, and whenever you recompile, you will get the exception error, that is the checked exception error, and that is what unreported exception, IO exception, and file not found exception also will give you the error. So you just need to throw the exception. So if you write here throws exception, your checked will be converted into unchecked. Now you can save this. Now you can compile this particular code. This code is compiled successfully. But whenever you run this, you will get an error. And the error is what? See, not a serializable exception. It means that this student must be the serialized if you want to write the object into the file. So it is very, very simple. You just need to write here, this student is implements serializable interface. Serializable is the marker interface, so you don't need to write any method over here. You just need to write implements serializable. Now you can compile your code demo1.java. Definitely it will be compiled and you can run this. The record will be written into the file. Now you can check your file. Here you will be able to see that the file is created. You can just edit this file. This file is not readable. Now I want to read this content. So for that, I want to create a new file, that is the demo2.java. Now I want to read the content. So I'm just writing here, that is demo2. And I don't want to create here class, right? And I want to read the content in my student object. So how we can read this object? It is very simple. Whenever you want to read the object, instead of this object output stream, you can write object input stream. And you can write that OIS is equal to new object input stream. Input stream is used to read the content and output stream is used to write the content. So here you can write file input stream. So the data will be read from this file, that is a student.txt. And instead of this write object, you can call the function read object. So read object will return the object. Now we know that we have written the student object. So we will cast this data into student object. And here we can write student s1 is equal to this student. And here you can simply print System.out.println S1. So what happened? It will read the content from the file. It will load into this object student S1 and you can print your object. And one more thing that I need to take care is what? This is OIS.read object. This is OIS.close. Now you can save this. You can compile your code Java C demo2.java and you can run Java demo2. You will get the object. It means that using demo1, I write the object using object output stream, and using demo2, I read the object using object input stream. So this is the way we can write an object to a file and we can read the object from a file. So that's it from my side. If you like this video, then please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.